Japan is a nation with a long-standing tradition of combining cutting-edge technology with military strategy. From the days of the samurai and the legendary katana to the advanced fighter jets of today, Japan has always embraced innovation on the battlefield. But while the katana once symbolized Japan's military prowess, that role is now being taken over by something far more futuristic. A sixth-generation stealth fighter that Japan is developing in partnership with the United Kingdom and Italy. This collaboration, known as the Global Combat Air Program, or GCAP, is setting the stage for a new era in aerial warfare. In today's video, we'll explore how this ambitious project is taking shape, what it means for Japan's independence in military aviation, and how it could reshape the global balance of air power. Across the globe, air forces and navies are racing to define what the sixth generation of fighter aircraft will look like. While each country brings its own requirements and vision to the table, a few core characteristics are common across all of these next-gen jets. First, digital engineering plays a central role in design and manufacturing, allowing aircraft to be simulated, tested, and even modified virtually. Then there's the integration of artificial intelligence, not to replace the pilot, but to act as a co-pilot, assisting with tactical decision-making in the chaos of combat. These jets will be networked like never before, with advanced communication systems capable of transferring massive amounts of data between manned aircraft, drones, and battlefield command centers in real time. Optional piloting is another breakthrough feature. Future fighters could fly either with or without a human on board. Human system integration is also being revolutionized. Think virtual cockpits that display flight data directly on a pilot's helmet, replacing traditional instrument panels. Weapon systems will also be next level. Expect the integration of hypersonic missiles, laser-based directed energy weapons, and stealth features advanced enough to evade even the most sophisticated infrared search and track IRST systems used by enemy aircraft. Japan has long been considering building its own next-generation fighter, but until recently, it mostly relied on licensed foreign designs. Take the Mitsubishi F-2, for example. It's a locally modified version of the American F-16 Fighting Falcon. Before that, there was the Mitsubishi F-1, developed in the 1970s, which many called the Japanese twin of the British-French Sepakat Jaguar. By the early 2010s, Japan's Ministry of Defense began seriously evaluating the need for an indigenous replacement for its aging F-2 fleet. The conclusions were clear. Japan needed to develop a homegrown fighter. The urgency of this decision was amplified by rapid Chinese military modernization, frequent incursions by Russian aircraft into Japanese airspace, and growing missile threats from North Korea. These challenges led to the birth of the I-3 fighter concept, short for informed, intelligent, and instantaneous. The I-3 fighter wasn't just another stealth jet, it was envisioned as a counter-stealth platform, one capable of detecting and neutralizing enemy stealth aircraft before they could strike. To do this, the jet would rely on a powerful radar system, an advanced sensor suite, secure communications with drones and satellites, and the ability to coordinate attacks with unmanned escort aircraft. Together, these features would give Japan the edge in regional air superiority. In 2018, Japan took a significant step forward when IHI Corporation unveiled a prototype of the XF-9-1 engine, a powerful lightweight turbofan designed for stealth applications. By 2020, the Ministry of Defense officially transitioned from the R3 concept to the FX program, assigning Mitsubishi Heavy Industries as the lead developer. One of the driving forces behind this domestic push was Japan's inability to procure the F-22 Raptor from the United States due to the Obey Amendment, a U.S. law that prohibits the sale of the F-22 to foreign governments. With that option off the table, Japan realized it had no choice but to build its own. The Mitsubishi FX was envisioned as a large twin-engine stealth fighter with dimensions that even exceeded those of the F-22, leading aviation journalists to nickname it Godzilla. But it wasn't just about size, the FX would also be a technological marvel. Unlike previous jets that used bulky hydraulic systems, the FX would utilize electric actuators. This not only saved weight, but also allowed engineers more freedom in the internal layout. Essential for accommodating stealth-friendly features like serpentine air intakes and an internal weapons bay. To further reduce its radar signature, the aircraft would use carbon fiber reinforced polymer composites, adhesive molding instead of traditional fasteners, and special electromagnetic wave absorbing materials around the engines and ducts. Even the aircraft's sensors would be smart enough to manipulate their radar emissions, a kind of digital camouflage. On the detection front, the FX would be equipped with an advanced active electronically scanned array, AESA, radar, a passive radio frequency detection system, and infrared sensors. Its radar system, reportedly modeled after the American APG-81 found in the F-35, would allow for multi-target tracking even against stealthy foes. Cooling all this high-tech equipment is another major challenge. Mitsubishi solved this by incorporating a hybrid cooling system based on vapor compression refrigeration, a technique similar to what's used in air conditioners, combined with traditional air and liquid-cooled components. The XF9-1 engines were especially well-suited for this role. Their compact design, 30% smaller in inlet size compared to the F110 engines used in the F2, made them ideal for stealth jets. Two XF91s would generate over 360 kilowatts of power and feature 3D thrust vectoring nozzles capable of deflecting thrust by 20 degrees, giving the FX remarkable agility. And what about firepower? The FX would carry Japan's latest supersonic anti-ship missile, the ASM-3, developed by Mitsubishi. Two versions are already planned: the extended-range ASM-3A and a mysterious variant known only as ASM-3Kai, details of which remain classified. But here's where the story takes a surprising turn. In 2022, anonymous sources revealed that Japan and the UK were planning to merge their respective sixth-generation programs, the Japanese FX and the British Tempest, into a single unified project. By December, the Global Combat Air Program was officially announced, with Italy joining as the third key partner. This wasn't entirely unexpected. Originally, Britain had tried to collaborate with France and Germany under the FCAS program, but political disagreements and industrial conflicts derailed that plan. In contrast, Japan offered Britain a partner with cutting-edge technology, a shared interest in export-friendly design, and, most importantly, no internal squabbles. Under the GCAP agreement, Mitsubishi Heavy Industries and BAE Systems would lead the project. IHI and Rolls-Royce would co-develop the engines, Leonardo of Italy would handle electronics, and MBDA would develop the missile systems. Meanwhile, a joint radar project called JAGUAR, Japan and Great Britain Universal Advanced Radar, was also launched in early 2022 to enhance sensor capabilities for the new aircraft. So what will this new fighter look like? The GCAP design is said to be roughly 30% larger than the Eurofighter Typhoon and similar in weight to the legendary F-15 Eagle. It will feature an enormous delta wing with a 50-degree sweep, stretching 54 feet across and boasting a surface area almost as large as a narrow-body Airbus A320. A concept model was revealed at the Farnborough Air Show in 2024. While it's still early, this design suggests a focus on long-range capability, heavy payload capacity, and high-speed flight, possibly at the cost of some maneuverability compared to the original FX concept. British aviation journalist Gareth Jennings even likened the wingspan to that of the retired American F-111 bomber, although the GCAP won't rely on low-altitude penetration tactics like the F-111 did. Instead, it aims to blend stealth, standoff weapons, and long reach, more like a spiritual successor to the canceled FB-22 stealth bomber concept. All three partner nations currently operate versions of the F-35, but the GCAP jet is being developed as a complementary platform, one that offers greater versatility, higher payloads, and the freedom to integrate domestic weapons like Japan's ASM-3, the MBDA Meteor, and a new joint air-to-air missile, JAM. This missile is rumored to combine Japanese radar homing technology with a British-designed Meteor ramjet propulsion system. While it may not be quite as fast as the Meteor, topping out around Mach 3.5, it will be a formidable weapon in its own right. So when will it fly? The first demonstrator flight for the Tempest concept is expected in 2027. According to UK defense officials, it will offer a good preview of the technologies that will make their way into the final GSAP production aircraft. Full operational capability, however, isn't expected until the mid-2030s. That timeline might sound long, but it's typical for a program of this magnitude. Even the United States has faced delays with its own sixth-generation jet under the Next Generation Air Dominance, NGAD, program. The real question is, can GCAP beat NGAD to the skies, or will it fall into the same development traps as Europe's stalled FCAS effort? Let us know what you think in the comments. Will Japan's partnership with the UK and Italy give them the edge, or are we in for another decade-long wait before the next generation of air dominance takes flight? If you enjoyed this deep dive, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and ring that notification bell so you never miss our takes on the future of military and aviation tech. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.